Welcome to another Stories from the Stores, joined today by curator Alex Rose, and she's telling us about Britain's obsession with the weather, or at least clouds. What's going on, Alex?
People have long been fascinated with the clouds, but clouds have long been a problem for scientists because they're so transient. By the time you've described one, it's kind of changed into something else. So they always felt like they were beyond scientific description.
I mean, is there really any scientific description needed? Because you've got three: big, small, dinosaur.
Yeah, I mean, that pretty much sums it up. But there was a man working in the early 19th century who wanted to give more scientific names to the clouds. So he came up with a classification system that divided them into, well, three main families. He gave them Latin names, though. So he called them cirrus, which is the Latin word for curl of hair, stratus, which means layer, and cumulus, which means heap or pile. In order to capture the sky that he was looking at and help his own understanding, he made lots and lots of sketches and watercolours of the sky and the cloud structures. And that was what helped him to see patterns in what he was looking at and to come up with his classification system.
So are these sort of specific forms of clouds here?
Yeah, that's right. So here we've got mostly got a cumulus cloud, so the heap or pile, and there's also some cirrus and stratus up in the sky. This one is a kind of hybrid version, so Howard also wanted to describe how clouds changed, how they join together and split apart. So this is a cumulostratus cloud.
So you're saying it's science, but this looks more like art. Why did he draw these?
So it was to help him sort of understand his own observations because the clouds kept changing. So he needed to find a way of recording them and comparing things he'd seen from day to day. On these, he worked with another artist who filled in the landscapes. But artworks like these were essential for him communicating his ideas to the wider scientific world.
Okay, so he's classified the clouds from these drawings, but why do we care?
That's a good question. So when Howard was working, meteorology was still a really young science, and it was still very much about gathering as much data as you possibly could and as many observations as you could, and kind of hoping that patterns would appear from those observations. But Howard's scheme allowed us to start to view the clouds in a scientific way.